Uh-oh. You was on the interstate today and you got a drivetrain malfunction error code. There might be other vehicles that does this exact drivetrain malfunction, but I don't think so. I think it's a BMW thing.
Get fixed. Let's get it.
We're going to be going through the process of elimination and trying to figure out exactly what is going on with your vehicle. And here's how we're going to do that. That error message is pertaining to some type of electronic on your engine that is going out. The ECU is basically the brain of your car. It stands for Electronic Control Unit. Now, what that basically does is it communicates with all the other modules within the car and tries to figure out what is going on with it. If a specific signal is sent from a module, it's able to tell you, yo, pay attention to this, look at this, there may be something going on here. Some type of circuitry breakage could cause a signal to be sent over to the ECU. Your ECU is the brain of the car and it communicates and operates with all the modules within the car that uses electronic signals or communication. Now that we have the basic fundamentals out of the way as to how your drivetrain malfunction message pops up, now we're going to be talking about the troubleshooting steps to figuring out what is going on and how to resolve it. Here's the conditions of exactly what happened right after that error message popped up. The car started to act different. For example, when he starts up the car, you can hear it sputtering and it kind of struggles to start. And then it starts shaking as he begins to accelerate, right? Now, the next condition is once he floors it or hits the gas, and my car is extremely quick, but once he floors it to go accelerate, it'll slowly and gradually accelerate up to whatever speed he's trying to get up to, but you can't feel that torque happen. So drivetrain malfunction, the ECU will turn off the torque to prevent you from damaging the engine. Now that you know why your car is acting the way it is, we're going to be using those conditions to figure out exactly what's going on. The first time that's ever happened in my life, I was able to quickly troubleshoot it and I was able to figure out exactly what that problem is. I was coming home from the gym at night and as soon as I made it to a red light, the car started shaking, sputtering, and then turned off on me. I was like, what the fuck? I just got the car. That's never happened to me before. Why is that happening now? I went to go start it. The car came back on and started shaking. I'm like, bro, is my engine messed up right now? And then drivetrain malfunction popped up. I did have my scanner on me, and I carry my scanner at all times just in case anything comes up. I'm able to scan and diagnose. I was able to pull up an error code. I believe it was P0204. P0204 basically means one of your fuel injectors is out. P0204 told me exactly which one went out. What a fuel injector does is whenever you press the gas, that's you demanding the ECU to output gas into the cylinder of the engine, right? Because one of the fuel injectors went out, whenever the ECU gives it the command to put gas inside of the engine, it couldn't do it. Or if it was doing it, it was dripping into the cylinder versus actually spitting out the exact amount that it needs in order to propel the car forward. You're going to get a lot of sputtering because of backfiring, improper fuel injection into that cylinder, and your car is going to be acting all types of funny. In some scenarios, it's going to be shaking so hard that you are not going to want to drive it because you're so scared of damaging the engine. I don't recommend you drive it in a condition as bad as it's shaking, and you can literally feel every single thing shaking. Mine is doing that right now, but on a moderate level, not a crazy shaking sensation like it did to me before. If you don't have access to a scanning tool, you are able to go to your local AutoZone, just ask for an OBD2 scanner, and they'll give it to you. You simply go over to your car, put the car in accessory mode. For push to start, you just press it without hitting the brakes. For something that uses a key, you just turn it into position 2, accessory mode. Anyways, you switch it over to accessory mode. The radio is going to be on, the AC might be on, but the car itself is not on. Then you want to plug the scanner into the OBD port. And then automatically, that scanner will start scanning the car. If you have your own, you are going to have to trigger it for it to scan the car. Once the AutoZone device scans the car, it'll store the code into the device. And then it'll tell you to bring it back to somebody inside of the store. They'll be able to plug it up to their computer and then they could pull out the code and print out exactly what's going on with your vehicle. It may be your spark plugs, it may be your coil, it may be your fuel injectors, but it'll narrow it down to a region of the engine where you're like, okay, based off these conditions, I could kind of tell this is the problem with my car. The reason I was able to narrow it down literally within minutes is because I've experienced this in the past before, and I do a lot of troubleshooting when it comes to vehicles, so I know exactly how to narrow it down to the basic fundamentals and the basic problems because I know how the car is supposed to operate, and under these specific conditions, I could kind of tell. Look at this. The purpose of this video was to show you how to use process of elimination to figure out what a problem is and how to resolve it. Part 2 to this video is going to be teaching you how to replace the fuel injector on the 2015 BMW 328i. I have done it in the past before, but I did not record it. But thank God, this part has warranty to it. So once I replace it, I can bring the old part back and they'll give me $120 right back, right off the bat. All parts needed for this repair is going to be down in the video description below and the next video I upload teaching you how to repair this exact issue. The error code is P0204. Look into it if it matches your conditions. Anyways, guys, BenjiD here from Get Fixed, and I'm out. Peace.
Let's get it.